glimpse of it on the outside. It's grisly, unfortunately, this morning, although it's quite warm. So we're now going to go in and investigate. And so it's in a little square, as you can see here.
Skills in communication, so ladies and gentlemen,
this
is Ugo Bardi.
Sì.
Speaking to you from the other hemisphere of the world. We are in Firenze right now, it's Sunday afternoon, it's a very rainy day, and we are sitting all together, some Bardis. Not exactly all of us are Bardis, but at least every one of us is some Bardi ancestor. And and then I don't know anymore what to say, so you can shift it to somebody else.
What do you do in Florence?
What do I do in Florence? I have a coffee with some nice ladies from Australia.
Your work? What sort of
my work? I spend my time in my office, where I have a computer, a telephone, and I try always to put my computer in between myself and the people who are trying to bother me all the time. But in reality, I think at some moments of my life, I do teach chemistry to some very intelligent so-and-so students.
At a university? Or?
At the university, yes.
Which university is
the
that?
University of Firenze. There is only one here.
Oh, only one. Right. Thank you. Right now.
I'm not a Bardi. I just married a Bardi.
Yeah, this was bad
for
you.
Very lucky.
Well, I hope, I think I'm lucky. And I run a gallery, an art gallery in Florence.
And that, what's in that gallery?
Name of the gallery?
No, what's in the gallery? Bronze and marble?
Bronze and marble replicas of classic culture, Italian and Greek classic culture, and Renaissance, mostly Renaissance.
And who would buy that? What sort of?
We export all over the world, in Australia.
Really?
Sure.
It's beautiful.
Ladies, you can bring a brochure with you if you can make some tea or some business. You know it.
Yeah, we have few clients in Australia. Yeah. And we had one from Adelaide, but we have few from Sydney and Melbourne and Victoria.
Yeah.
We even shipped to Tasmania.
But not Adelaide.
And people that come from there are very impressed because you don't have anything like that.
No. And were you born in Florence?
I'm born here. Yeah. I was born here.
And you've lived here all your life?
Not far from here.
Oh, right. Mm-hmm.
We still are from the generation who marry very, very close people living here.
Oh, yeah, my family live here, so and his family live here. And all the style Italian, you know.
Yeah,
very good.
So we are very close to all the relatives, and we meet quite often. So.
And tell me about your children. You have two children.
We have two children. One, Francesco, the oldest.
How old is he?
16. But he was born in California, because at that time my husband was a visiting professor in Berkeley, so he was born there. But he feels very Italian anyway.
So he's got dual citizenship,
yes, he has a double citizenship. And Donata, she's 9, still in elementary school.
She was born
the Christmas night, on Christmas Eve. Christmas night, so that's why her name is Donata, that means given, it's a kind of gift.
Lovely.
So maybe your mother will recognize this word.
Yeah. We have a sister born on Christmas Eve too, haven't we, but she didn't call her that.
She was born on Christmas night, so it's already
Christmas night.
It's a real Christmas gift.
Right.
Okay. Deve dire chi è lei.
Io sono Bardi Renza, figlia di Raffaello Bardi, il mio nonno Antonio, che lo ricordo benissimo.
Buonasera.
E allora io sono qua, sono la maggiore di 6 fratelli. ai quali ancora siamo ancora tre vivi. E allora io auguro a voi tante buone cose e anche a noi di buona salute. Grazie.
Okay, I can translate.
Yeah, translate now.
Okay, she said her name is Renza Bardi. She had the oldest of six children of this grand family. And still three of them are alive, and two died when they were young children. At that time, it was very common here. And she remembers very well the grandfather Antonio, who was the painter. She's probably the only one who really remembers him, because she used to live together when she was a young child. She lived together with the grandparents.
Okay.
So, and she's very happy to meet you and to see you here in Florence. And she wish you a good health and a nice trip back to Australia.
Okay. You say hello to Australia.
Hello, I'm Francesco. I'm 16. Stop.
And you're still at school?
Yes.
Yes, and what are you going to do when you leave school?
I don't know.
Not yet. Okay.
Sounds like...
Mm-hmm. Okay,
grazie. My name is Donata.
That's lovely. How old are you, Donata?
I am nine.
She speaks beautiful English too. Do you want to say something in Italian?
Of course,
in
Italiano.
Say hello, Australia.
Faccio la pizza in Italia.
Hello, Australia. Dici
che mi piacerebbe andare in Italia.
Okay.
Clever. She would like to go to Australia and see the kangaroo.
Oh, okay. Lovely.
And the koala.
And the koala. Lovely.
Okay. Cosa fai? Come si chiama?
Allora, Antonio Bardi, nato a Firenze naturalmente nel 1929. 29. Ora risiedo a un'altra zona di Firenze, al Campo di Marte, vicino allo stadio comunale.
Fa l'architetto?
Sono architetto, ho la libera professione e ho lo studio in via Benivieni, numero 13, a Firenze. Ho due figlie.
Ecco.
E poi
fra un po' due nipoti.
Una a dicembre, un'altra non so di preciso anno nuovo, nasceranno due bambini, due nipoti.
Okay, he said his coordinates, where he lives, where is he studied, that he's an architect, that he can design a house for you if you ever need.
Something
like that. And
yes, please.
He has two daughters, and both daughters are expecting a child, so they will be born next year, both. So he's soon to become a grandfather.
Oh, lovely. Thank you.
Okay, hello, Alan. I'm not sure I can pronounce your name well enough, but I hope I did. And it was very nice of you to help our friends here to discover us in the internet. And maybe we could put something on the internet about this international encounter that we had here from people coming from so far away. Maybe we could make a mailing list or something like that. And anyway. Maybe one of these days or years or millennia, because we are switching millennium, in a short time we could meet some place. Okay, have a nice time in Australia.
Grandmother Rita.
Right.
Okay.
So that's Antonia.
This is Raffaello. Raffaello is my grandfather and the father of Renzo and of Antonio.
There are quite interesting things in this house. It's rather special.
Yeah.
It's, for instance, this.
Oh.
This is some memorabilia of my aunt. This is again my aunt Anna.
All right. Yeah.
Anna in a painting, a self-portrait she made of herself the day of her marriage.
Oh.
And there was, it's beautiful. There was her husband was here.
Okay, but she herself removed it after. So I'm not going to tell you exactly the details, but you can understand a few things. And, oh, this is again my aunt and Francesco when he was very young, and this is her. How do you call this in English? I don't know.
Blackboard?
Not the blackboard, it's the place where you paint. It's
easel.
Easel, yes. Mm-hmm. And okay, with a few things.
That's cool.
What the hell? This is some instruments. This is real beautiful object. Yeah. This used to belong to my grandfather. And it's fantastic. It's a place I was
making the gesture
of a computer, but it is not a computer, but it's an ancestor. It's an ancestor object. You can see some wonderful things here. We can place documents here. There are some places for hidden documents and for...
Io non l'avevo mai aperto.
This is a fantastic object. I like it so much when I was a child. Non distruggerlo comunque, Donata. And it was used, it was a working desk. Used before the war. It's, I think it's almost 100 years old. It's more modern.
This is... Look at Francesco. Here's a smile. Okay. So this is a peach tree here.
Peach tree.
Che frutti
sono?
What's this little one's name? Benetta.
Anyway, you can still see here traces of this garden once was former. Italian garden. There are still traces that were symmetric. It was a square grid of paths. It was very ambitious now to go over the
years.
Almost all disappeared. But... May and houses, all the same. This one is special because it's the last one of the row, so the garden is has this strange shape, and as a compensation, there's another garden on the other side. Mm-hmm. This is really very small.
That's just a little garden house down there.
The neighbors do something, I remember. Long ago, there was a how do you call that? A chicken house, yes.
Right.
I remember when I was a child, it was very interesting for me, this place.
The 1913.
My aunt says she knows the time when this object was built, and it's 1913.
No, really?
Grandmother, yes.
And
the grandfather, great grandfather, he's the painter actually.
Get in. That's it. Now I want you. Okay, all say hello or something. We're just up on the courtyard, aren't we? Can you call a courtyard?
Courtyard,
yeah.
Hiya!
Hello everyone. This is the body. Don't move it around too much,
you'll
be shaking.
Okay. Non
agitare
troppo. Sennò... Turn it off. I don't know how to turn it off.
It's hard to turn off. Oh no, that's good.
No.
Chamber, the bedroom of the grandparents. Our grandparents, Francesco's great-grandparents. They both died here in this room. The room has remained as it was for about 20 years now.